What's going on, guys? Troy here with TJ Lawn and Landscape, and in today's video I want to show you real quick how to do an oil change on the Cup Cadet CC 800 walk behind. Let's get into it. Alright guys, so as you can see here, I already have the oil draining, but let me show you how I did it. When I bought the Cup Cadet, it did come with this little tube here, and I've kept that. If you see here this little yellow valve, I actually wanted to let this all drain before I showed you this, but for the most part now, we're just trickling. So let me put this towel here and pull that. Now let me show you. This is what the little oil drain valve is going to look like when you go to start. So what you got to do is you pop off this little black cap right here. That's not going to look like that. That's only because I was just draining the oil. But if you can see on the side, it's a little difficult, but right there is a little thing where you twist this, right? And get it to where there's that long little section there, and then you pull it out. Oops, see, and then that's when it starts draining. I guess it's not completely done yet. I only want to make this video real quick because when I started doing this, the oil change, the Cup Cadet just said 50 hours. That's why I needed to do it. I didn't know how to do the oil change on this because I didn't know where the oil came out or how to do that little thing with the oil drain valve. So that's why I'm making this video. But other than that, obviously you're probably servicing your own right now. Let me go over some other stuff. Pretty self-explanatory. Right here is the spark plug, so you just pull this little thing off right here, and that's how you can get to the spark plug. The oil filter is right here, and to get to the air filter, you just unscrew these little latches right here. I actually broke one of mine and popped this off. You have your fuel filter right here, and this is where you put in your new oil. It does take 10W30. All right, so as you can see, everything was pretty much stripped from the mower. Took off the oil filter, the air filter. I left the fuel filter for now because I want to do that last. I just don't want any fuel spilling out while I do that. All right, sorry for the lighting, but this mower takes 3 pints of 10W30. Honestly, since all my mowers are John Deere, I have this stuff sitting around. This is what I'm going to use. Since they are both 32 fluid ounces each, I'll be using 1.5. Now, as long as your hands are dry enough, I only recommend never like hand tightening that as much as you can. You don't need to go super tight with it. Now, if you are like me, you're using 2 32 fluid ounce bottles, I would probably write on here, it shows on the side how much you have left, but just write you have 16 fluid ounces left and what date you opened this. Yes, like I said, on the side it can show here, so every few, you know, little bits of pours, I'm gonna check to see how much is left. Just about 16 on the dot. Air filter. So one thing I'm realizing as I'm doing the fuel filter, sorry for the angle here, is the gas tank is up here. And I don't see anywhere to kind of shut off the flow of gas. So this is gonna be fun. I also just accidentally dropped the new fuel filter, and it's all the way over there. Yeah. All right. I put it back the way it was, and now I'm washing my hands. I gotta touch the camera, but I want to show you guys. I don't know if I'm messing something up here or if this was a design flaw, but just being honest, like, look at this. I don't know how the angle is, yeah, but right there, that's where the tube is coming out, and it goes right here. There's no way to shut off gas coming to this tube right now. So as soon as I take this off, gas is coming out. I am not siphoning all the gas out to do this. But, you know, I'm probably just going to use my finger to cork it real quick and replace what I have to. This is what I'm talking about. Gas is getting everywhere. Oh, there we go. Cork that. Christ, dude. Alright, well, that's that. All right, am I missing anything? Spark plug, yes. We did the oil change with the oil filter. We did the air filter and the fuel filter. All that's left is spark plug. Now, this was kind of annoying to get out in the first place, and sorry for this angle here, but I feel like it's only gonna be even more annoying to get in. All right, guys, the last bit of this recording actually got a little corrupted. I don't know what happened to the footage, but obviously you can see tighten down the spark plug. You can use a little socket set or whatever to make sure it's really snug in there. Once that's done, you pretty much have serviced everything about your Cub Cadet 33-inch walk behind. So again, thank you for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe. I'll see you in the next one.